गुड इवनिंग। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द कॉर्पोरेट न्यूज़ डेटेड 24 मई 2022। सो स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट न्यूज़ वी हैव, ताज विल एग्जिट नॉन कोर एसेट्स एंड फोकस ऑन होटल्स। इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट हॉस्पिटैलिटी चेन ताज विल सेट अप द सेल ऑफ इट्स नॉन कोर एसेट्स। ताज हैड रेस्ड अबाउट ₹500 crore फ्रॉम द सेल ऑफ नॉन स्ट्रेटेजिक एसेट्स सच एज रेजिडेंशियल अपार्टमेंट्स एंड होटल्स इन द लास्ट 4 fiscals। फॉर द नेक्स्ट न्यूज़ वी हैव, गौतम अदानी एंड मुकेश अंबानी आर एट अ टर्निंग पॉइंट इन देयर राइवलरी। अदानी द वर्ल्ड 6th richest person हैज एडेड ऑलमोस्ट $30 billion टू हिज वेल्थ दिस ईयर, मोर देन एनी अदर बिलियनेयर। हिज नेटवर्थ ऑफ $106 billion इज ऑनली अबाउट हाफ ऑफ टेस्ला इनकॉर्पोरेशन को फाउंडर इलॉन मस्क, बट $10 billion मोर देन अंबानीज। सो इन द चार्ट ऑन द राइट we can see the net debt and EBITDA component. Net debt is basically shown by the blue circle and the EBITDA column is shown by the white circle. So in the chart on the right, we can see two components, net debt and EBITDA. Net debt is shown by the blue circle while the EBITDA is shown by the white circle. So basically there are two companies which have been significantly hit by these two, namely Adani Transmission, which we can see over here, and Adani Enterprise on the second that we can see over here. Then in the next chart we can see net debt to EBITDA ratio, which measures that the company may have too much debt than it can handle. So over here we can see that Adani Wilmar has the lowest debt to EBITDA ratio, indicating that the company is maintaining its debt adequately, while in the contrast we have Adani Transmission over here, where we can see that it has the highest ratio of about 12.9 times. So basically it can be seen by this white line or white bar graph, you can say. So after that, on the left I have basically measured all the ratios of the other companies in the similar fashion, and basically starting from Adani Transmission, then Adani Enterprise, and then Adani Power, followed by Adani Ports, Adani Green Energy, Adani Total Gas, and finally the Adani Wilmar. After that we have Zomato quarter 4 results. Net loss widens to ₹359 crore despite 75% jump in the revenue. So basically the food aggregator Zomato on May 23rd reported a net loss of ₹359 crore in the fourth quarter of fiscal year 2021 to 2022, and the company's revenue during the same period climbed to ₹1,211.8 crore. So further analyzing the adjusted revenue part, we can see that there has been a decrease in quarter on quarter growth from quarter 1 financial year 2022 to quarter 4 financial year 2022 from 234% to 67%. After that we will come to adjusted EBITDA. So basically we can see that there has been an improvement from quarter 2 financial year 2022 from -22% to quarter 4 financial year 2022 to -15%. So the reason for that is because there has been an increase in monthly active restaurant and delivery partners to 204,000, 316,000 respectively, compared to 191,000, 296,000 in quarter 3. So after that, we can see the Broadcom in advanced talks to buy VMware. Broadcom Incorporation is in talks to acquire cloud computing company VMware Incorporation, according to the people familiar with the matter, setting up a blockbuster tech deal that would vault the chip maker into a highly specialized area of software. After that, for the final news we have, Aditya Birla Fashion to raise ₹2,195 crore from GIC. GIC will own around 7.5% equity stake in ABFRL after the investment. Aditya Birla Group will hold around 52% stake in the company post the completion of its transaction. This fashion retailer says it plans to use its capital to accelerate the growth engine built around its current businesses, along with the rapidly evolving play in emerging high growth business models. So please do subscribe. Like and share the video to show your appreciation, and you can contact us from the details given below via phone number, email address or WhatsApp. And that's all for today. Thank you.